Hallelujah, glory to God. Okay, so I just want to take my time to really talk about this issue that I want to talk about, pastors that is taking people to court. It's a shameful something, it's a shameful thing for what is happening, especially in Nigeria. It's a disgraceful thing. What is happening in Nigeria, Nigerian churches? I saw a video, not a video, it's real. Mountain of Fire pastor, the Lord of Asia, or the choir, suing a Showole, a Nigerian presidential candidate for next year. I saw that he sued this man, I don't know how many billion that he sued the man. I say, for what? For what reason? For what? A pastor? A man of God? For what? Let me tell you something. I said it earlier, Mountain of Fire is not a church. It's not a church. It's a gathering of witches and wizards. That gathering is the people that install this man. I said it earlier, and I repeat it again. It's witches and wizards that install him in that thing that he's doing, call himself man of God or a pastor or whatever thing that he's calling himself. That church is witches and wizard church. And what I see him trying to do is witch hunt. It's a witch hunt. Want to young man that have come out to speak the truth about you people, about what he found out, and he keep finding out every day about all the evil and atrocity people are doing in the name of the Lord, you are suing him. It's supposed to be a shame. You are suing a young man for the truth that he is speaking. I also see that all of you are into politics. All of you are politicians. It's a way you want to like to bring him down or to dent his ambition. No, to dent him. You cannot dent him. You cannot. Because this man is more powerful than you people because of the truth he's speaking. This young man is more powerful than all of you that is carrying Bible, that is calling yourself, you can command fire to fall, you can heal all sickness, you can heal all disease. Why can't you leave that matter to God and tell God to go and fight for you? That if what he's saying or what he's doing is wrong, let that God, you said that God is all powerful. God is able to fight for his servants. God is able to. You can go on your knees and bring this man to the throne of God. Bring him to the court of heaven and tell them, see what this man is saying or doing about you. If you know that God is pleased with you, that God is with you, you take him to God and let God polish him, let God handle him. That you move straight to court. You drag him to court, thinking, if I ever take him to court, I will win. It's not somebody that called police that will win. If this young man is speaking the truth, God is with him. God is backing him up. You take him to court, it doesn't make any sense. It's for me, it's nothing. It's useless. Nothing. Pastors, men of God, any little thing you will drag people to court, sue them for money to show that this is what people are worshiping. Mammon, money, this is what people are worshiping. Businessmen, dirty businessmen, not even a clean one, dirty businessmen. It's witch hunt, you want to hunt him, you cannot hunt him. The same fire you're calling will consume you. You can't hunt him. You can't hunt him. Let the will of God be done in Nigeria. Let the will of God be done in the whole world. Let the will of God be done now. not the will of man. The will of God is what must, and what is happening now. The will of God, not the will of you fake pastors that have been deceiving people, lying to them. Anytime election, is approaching, people will devise one evil means to make money or to take money from people or to, all these things shows that people doesn't know God. Don't know God. Why are you suing him? Why drag him to court? Drag him to the court of heaven. Take him to the court of heaven. If your way pleases God, if you know that God is one that ordained you, that God is one that anointed you, take him to the court of heaven. God is the chief judge of the Supreme Court in heaven. Let God judge him. If you know that you are at peace with God, that your way pleases God, that God is happy, that God is smiling, over your life. That God is smiling over what you mood and call church. That God is the one who done it. Take him to the court of heaven. You cannot stop the young man and you cannot dent him. So I want to advise you that your witch hunt cannot do anything, because it is not a surprise to me, because your church is witchcrafty. It's a witchcrafty church. It's a church of witchcraft, witchcraft people. This is what loaded in your church. Invite me to preach there. We set them on fire, all of them. I will set, even you yourself will be the first to fall down. I will set you on fire. I will set you on the real fire from heaven, the fire of the Holy Ghost. I will set you, everything will burn. Every human being will be set on fire, burning. You see how demon will be screaming and checking out of the people, out of you yourself, out of you. You will see, you'll be the first that will be knocked down by the power of the Holy Ghost that you are calling, that you don't even know. You are calling fake fire, mountain of fire. Fake fire. Fake. It's not original fire. Bring a true man of God, anointed, that is having God's spirit. You set everything on fire. You see that the fire of the Holy Ghost is real. That fire will disgrace all of you from head to toe. Okay, so I said, Mr. Showode, carry on. Showode, carry on. The Lord is your strength. The Lord is by your side. Carry on. Ride on. And may God help you and give you victory. I support you. I keep saying it. I support you. You are speaking truth. I love you for what is coming out of your mouth, for what you are speaking from your mouth, for the truth. And heaven is also happy for you. At least, we don't see, a presidential candidate that will be bold and is speaking about what is happening in Nigeria. It's a joyful thing in my heart. That even if you do not win, but I see you speaking the truth of what is going on in that country. Addressing issues without having any fear. Speaking to the people, telling people what they are doing, that alone I do like this for you. Nigeria, support him. Give your vote to this man. Give your vote to him. I see a future. If you people stand by the rightful person this time, things will turn around for good. Forget all these pastors. They're all promoters of evil. Don't believe their word. Don't believe their action. Don't believe. If they tell you anything, just run away from them. Don't vote for this person. Just vote the one that you are convinced that the person is a rightful person that deserves your vote.